Good morning, students. Welcome back to our class. Today we are going to read a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is Quality, and it is in your Honeycomb book. So, students, the name of the chapter is Quality. So, with this chapter, we are going to inculcate two Dalmia core values among the students. One is happiness, and the other is open-mindedness. So, back to our chapter. Quality. See, everything when we go to a market, we need what the first preference we give to the thing when we buy anything, what we say, we talk about the quality of that thing, whether it is of good quality or it is of bad quality. So the preference is the quality. Whether we are purchasing the book, the pages, the quality of the pages should be good. If we are purchasing dresses or clothes, the stuff should be good. And if we are purchasing shoes, again, the leather or the stuff of which that shoe is made should be of good quality. Students, today, as we all know, it is the time. As the time is going up, everything is changing. Because in the past, there were no advertisements. The shopkeepers used to sell their things on their own basis, but now everything has changed. Yes, but still, if the thing is changed, but still the quality matters. The creativity matters. Yes. So many shops are there. They do the advertisement of their products. And with that advertisement, we come to know that, oh, this is the thing which is coming in the market. So we buy that. But still, some people are there who are still in the business that we should always think one thing, and that is the work is worship. That means making shoes is also an art, making good shoes. So we are talking about the chapter Quality, and the author of this chapter is John Galsworthy. So this author and his father, they were the permanent customer to Mr. Jessler. Mr. Jessler, about whom we are going to read, the story matters about Mr. Jessler's brother. So students, this story is about the Jessler's brothers who were shoemakers. They used to make shoes on order. So you can see on the screen, these are the two Jessler brothers. So they owned a shop in a stylish part of London. That means their shop was in the stylish market. Yes, you can see the different other shops and Jessler's brothers' shop. You can see the barber shop, you can see the candy, the bakery. So these are the different. So they owned, the Jessler brother owned the shop in a stylish part of the London. The shop was very simple, but was as peaceful as a church. Why church? Why the church has been used, and why the adjective peaceful has been used? See, what Mr. Jessler used to say, that making shoes is an art. Yes, it is an art for me. And work is worship for me. That means I worship my work. If I do my work with full devotedness. So that is why they used to take the orders. Because making good shoes takes time. So students, because he worshiped his job, he worshipped his shoemaking, so that's why the church is used, because he used to do his work honestly and peacefully. That's why peaceful as a church, because there we only remember God, we only do prayer to God. We don't talk rubbish in the church. Yes? Similarly, in Jessler Brothers' shoe shop also, it was peaceful. Why? Because they used to never talk more about anything, any false things. So it was as peaceful as a church. The narrator knew the younger of the two brothers. So narrator, who is telling the story. So when his father also used to come there, and afterwards the narrator, when he was young, so he also used to come there. Because he had made his father's boot. Because he used to come with his father, and his father used to also take shoes from his shop. The Jasla brothers only made boots on order. So they used to make boots on order. Why? Because making good shoes takes time. So they used to bring good leather, good all the other materials, and then they used to make the boots. The boots crafted by the younger brother were pieces of art, and they lasted very long. Why? Why pieces of art? Because Mr. Jasler used to say that making shoes is an art. Nobody can make good shoes. So because it is an art. So whenever they used to make shoes, and the author's father or author used to take shoes from his shop, they used to say, oh, these boots are perfect. Perfect in good looking and perfect in everlasting. So how one of the boots made him and made a creaking sound. So one day when the author, he went to the shop and he ordered for a shoe, for a boot. And what happened? When he took that shoes, and afterwards, after 2-3 days, he came back to the shop. So what he is complaining, you can see on the screen. One of the boots you made makes a creaking sound, means some sound is coming in that. So now Mr. Jasler was a little bit confused, because any complaint regarding his shoes, that means blaming the god. So now what he's telling, okay dear, I promise to return you the money which I had charged from you if I am not able to repair them properly. So none of the shopkeepers promise like this. They say, no, we are not taking any guarantee. If once the thing is sold, once the good is sold, we don't have any guarantee about that good. If you take that good and if you take it at your home and it is broken, we never take any guarantee about that. But Mr. Jasler, he said that, no, I promise I will return you the money if I am not able to repair it properly. So he was angry that the big companies charged a lot of money for poor quality boots. Just because they advertise their products and they are least bothered about the stuff of that product. These big companies charge a lot of money for poor quality goods. Only through advertisements and not through quality work. Yes, he's telling that they just advertise about their products and they are not bothered about the quality. They make a lot of money only through advertisements and not through quality work. So they make a lot of money just because of the advertisement, not because of the quality work. Mr. Jasler is complaining. So when afterwards he went to the abroad, the author went to abroad, then afterwards when he came back, then he just wanted to meet Jasler brother. So he came there, and that his older brother had died. Now what he's telling, Jasler is telling, I am the younger Mr. Jasler, my brother died. So he was a little bit confused. Soon after, when this one older brother, Jasler brother was, he died. So soon after, the narrator went abroad, he went outside. After some years, when he came back, to complete the few orders he received due increasing competition. So when he came back, he was just going from that market, he thought to visit Mr. Jasler. When he went there, so he inquired about Mr. Jasler because he could not see him. He worked hard to complete the few orders he received. Then that person told him that Mr. Jasler, the younger brother, also died, and I have purchased this shop. And why he died? Because he used to just do work and work, and when he was not able to give the products on time, so slowly the customers decreased and there was shortage of money, and he died because of lack of food. So this was the conclusion, this was the ending of Mr. Jester, who was a skillful person, who was a devoted person, and just because he could not do any kind of wrong things with his product, so he could not survive in the modern world. So students, so he died, he had literally starved to death, working tirelessly on his boots, not eating food. People needed their orders delivered quickly. So when Mr. Jessler could not do for, he took time and made the finest boots possible. So he lost customers, spent the little money that he now earned on leather, and had none left for food. So whatever money he used to get, he used to put it on the leathers, nothing for the food. However, the man admitted that Mr. Jessler made good food. The author agreed with shock and respect for the dead shoemaker. So students, what the moral is of the story? That commitment, whatever you are making should be worked out. Because he used to commit that I will be giving you your shoes on this date and I will be making the best shoes. So he always remained with his commitment, and that's why he died, because at last he could not complete the work according to his commitment, and so the customers decreased and there was no money, no food, and he died due to starvation. So students, this is what the story is telling. The quality is the one which matters. Yes, to complete the few orders he received due to increasing competition, he worked hard to complete the few orders he received. So delays in delivery also led to loss of customers. So when he was not able to give the things, he spent all the money on leathers and on the rent of the shop and nothing for his food. So students, this is what I told you about the story. The moral is, you should be honest, you should be working hard, and you should always remain on your commitment. So students, this was all about the chapter, and we will be meeting in our next class. Till then, stay fit, stay healthy, stay at your home. Thank you. Have a nice day.